We use the internet for chatting, for documenting, for shopping, for planning. But we want to do it safely, and so we use encryption for things like financial security and privacy, both of which take many forms and reasons. So we've grown rather fond of that little lock in our browser bar. It makes us feel safe. We're on the right track. But what does it take to get the lock there? And how can all that break? How can we prevent it? Who and what are we trusting? And what are their motivations? First, we need to understand the very basics of establishing an HTTPS connection. When your computer wants to talk to the internet, not in plain text, there's an issue of knowing if who you're talking to is who they say they are, and deciding on the encryption method to use. Certificate authorities, or CAs, are little stick figures in powdered wigs, both verify if the computer you're talking to is who it says it is, and ensures the encryption is set. The server of yourfavoritedomain.com gets their certificate from the CA, and your browser checks if it trusts that CA. Any CA can say they trust any site because the cost is on them to verify, but also to be useful. This is one way we have the whole system operate at scale, but it also causes some problems. Here's how this can break in three examples. Heartbleed was a flaw in code that allowed a long string of information to be queried, rather than that query stopping at the shell. It was publicly debated because the code is open source. Everyone who cared to, and had understanding, could comment on and offer suggestions on recovery and fixes. This means recovery was fairly quick. Many eyes make a bug shallow. DigiNotar had the CA itself acting as a sort of infecting function, still handing out certificates, but in a way that those certificates enabled man-in-the-middle attacks. Once this became public knowledge, action had to be taken. Revoking the certificates would have brought the government to a standstill, so it was suggested that people simply stay off the internet. This shows that CAs are too big to fail in their current setup, but that not noticing and not acting allows bad actors to easily infiltrate the same number of users that make these CAs too big to fail. GoToFail had the CA skipped entirely, but browsers still trusting that one had been checked in with. This is also a flaw in code, but it took a while to go public. We become so attached to our little lock that we freak out when we realize how delicate it is. And so we would prefer to pretend that everything is golden rather than build better locks and mechanisms for certifying them. But if we're going to be safer in the ways we think HTTPS should make us safer, we must deal with the reality of the situation. So what reality is that? If any of these CAs are compromised, the whole system falls to bits. This is called a weakest link. DigiNotar showed that the system, as it is now, allows CAs to get away with not reporting or not being supported and not fixing their stuff, rather than being held accountable for breaks. This is called too big to fail, a term you might recognize from banking and the mess that we continue to be in. The example of DigiNotar also points out how information asymmetry and ineffective auditing schemes play into the ongoing man-in-the-middle attacks. We saw with Heartbleed that it's possible to repair large-scale problems, and that it gets done faster when it's open. Then we've got liability dumping. Right now, the people most affected by any issue are the users, who tend to be un- and misinformed, as well as not having any other options easy for security beyond going through CAs. Confused governments don't hold CAs accountable because of these too-big-to-fail issues. But why wouldn't the CAs hold themselves accountable for the good of the market and the goodness of their hearts? These are technical, political, economic, and social issues. We need to examine and understand them so we might build the web we want. Do you have a lock in your browser? Then this matters to you. Go read the paper. Join the discussion.